Hello my friends, how are you all? Welcome to my channel's tutorial section. Today we'll be learning how to carve a permanent maxillary lateral incisor. So let's start. First we'll start with marking the aspects of the tooth. Mesial, distal, palatal and labial. Now it will be marking the dimensions of the tooth. We know our crown portion measures 9 mm. We'll take 0.5 mm extra to have the ease of carving. And now the root length, which is 13 mm. Now we'll mark the central axis of the tooth. Just a rough guideline. Just connect these on the top of the block. Mark the mesodistal width of the crown, that is 6.5 mm, but we'll take a little extra to 7 mm. Mark it on the top of the incisal aspect of the block. And also on the opposite side. Now we'll cut straight along these markings to the crown length. Mark the labiolingual width of the crown, that is 6 mm. But here also we'll take a little extra to 6.5 mm. Mark it on the top of the incisal aspect of the block and also on the opposite side. Now we'll cut it straight down to the marking of the crown length to make a cuboid. Make straight parallel walls within the marked dimensions. Now mark the mesiodistal dimension at the cervical. Now make a cut or notch at this marking on both proximal sides. These notches will mark the start of the curvature or the contour that we require. Don't worry about the curvature of the cervical line, it will be made later. Okay, so now from the labial side, we should know that the distal outline has more curvature than the central incisor. With the crest of the contour in the middle of the middle third. And distal incisal angle is much more rounded off. Notice the angle of the cover I'm making to develop a curved surface in the middle. Mesial outline has comparatively less curvature and less rounded mesioincisal angle. Mesial outline is slightly distally inclined at cervical to give the crown distally tilted look. Also round off the mesioincisal angle. Now on the proximal side, we'll mark the labiolingual dimension at cervical, that is 5 mm. We'll make the notches at these marks at cervical. Make notches here as before in the cervical. Continue this notch mesiodistally. Do check for the central axis of the block. Next thing is to get the incisal edge in the center of the block. We have to keep the crest of contour near the cervical. To do so, we just need to keep the plane angulated from here. Start making plane of the labial side with flat side of the cover. Do it to the full width. Keep approaching the midline from labial side. Keep a check on the mid axis. The level of crest of curvature on labial side is almost at the same level as on palatal side, that is close to the cervical. See from the proximal side, we have got the bulge. We'll contour it, we'll round off the proximal line angles a bit. This midline will keep the incisal edge and the tip of the root in the same line. Okay, so now we'll do the same on the palatal aspect. Following the central axis of the block, do gross carving with the sharp curved side of the cover. Now we'll make the palatal concavity above the cingulum with the curved end of the blade. And as I have described in my earlier basic tips tutorial video, you can use this curved end or the discoid end to scoop out. This way we are getting the cingulum in the cervical third. Keep rounding off the sharp line angles. Okay, now we'll correct the prominence of the crest of the contour and make it subtle. Keep the crest of contour close to the cervical. After doing the gross corrections, now we are ready to prepare the lingual outline from the incisal aspect. But before that, we'll correct the curvature on the labial aspect. And slight curvature at the proximal line angles of the labial outline. We'll need to round off the line angles by running the flat side of the carver from labial to proximal side. Also keep cleaning wax flakes for proper visualization. See the curvature achieved on the labial side. Now we'll be shaping the palatal side into V shape as we did for the central incisor. Run the carver from the incisal edge level to the cingulum in downward direction. Just keeping both the marginal ridges equal and cingulum in the center. Keep rounding off the sharp line angles. Okay, now we need to develop the curvature of the cervical line on the labial side. Also give the curvature on the labial side at cervical third, following the cervical line. Next, make the incisal edge close to the midline. Now we'll round off from the mesiolabial and distolabial line angles, giving slight curvature to the labial outline. Smoothen all the surfaces with cotton before proceeding further to have a good look at the contours and the angles achieved, and do the corrections if any. Give curve to the proximal sides at cervical. See the mesial and distal outlines. More rounded curvature on the distal and comparatively less rounded mesial side. Now develop the incisal edge bevel in the same way as we did for the central incisor, keeping the carver blade inclined towards the palatal side. Keep the incisal edge thin. See, here is a slight sharp prominence. We'll reduce it with light strokes from the flat side. Notice the sharp shiny angle here. Round this off to give a slight curve look. Just give very light and gentle carver strokes. Keep rounding off the sharp line angles. Develop slight curvature of the cervical line at both labioproximal line angles. To get that scallop of the cervical. Recheck the contour and outline from the labial side. Recheck the incisal edge for the midline. Just slightly flatten the incisal third with the flat side of the carver. Be very gentle while carving. Okay, so we are done with the gross shaping of the crown portion. Now we'll carve the lingual fossa. Later incisor has a V-shaped lingual fossa. Simply start developing the marginal ridges in a V-shaped pattern. Use the tip of the flat side of the carver, mark the extension of the ridge and slowly carve to raise the ridge. After scribing the V shape, just carve out the lingual fossa in between. Use the curved end of the blade to carve the concavity. You can use the discoid end also to develop the concavity of the fossa. Keep in mind to retain the incisal edge. Lingual fossa will be in between the marginal ridges and the incisal edge. Keep cleaning with a clean soft cotton to visualize better. Define the lingual groove and the marginal ridge with the tip of the carver. So now we are done with the palatal groove and the lingual fossa. Now we'll begin the root carving. First of all, mark the root length again. Start cutting straight down from the curved side of the blade to the full length from the cervical level of the crown. Keep straightening the root using the flat side of carver. Let's clean up before proceeding. Okay, remember from the labial aspect, the root follows even taper till 2/3 length and then bends sharply in the apical third. First, clear the excess just to the level of cervical. Lightly define the cervical lines on the proximal. Mesial one is higher than the distal. From the proximal aspect, the root tip and the incisal edge coincides. And taper with blunt apex. Start carving, keeping in mind the taper and the apical bend. Let's verify the root length again. Keep developing the taper along the length of root. See, we are getting the root taper and the bend of the root end to the distal from the labial aspect. As I've told earlier, keep the root tip in the line with the incisal edge in the proximal aspect. Keep developing and finishing the taper along the length of root. Polish it well to remove all the minor irregularities. So our tooth is ready now. You can add details of lobes on the labial side if you like. Here's how to do that. Try to carve two V-shaped notches in the incisal tooth head. Just blend them on the labial surface. Polish it well to remove all the scratches. So that's how you carve a permanent maxillary latent incisor. I hope this video was useful. So keep watching and keep practicing.